Hey, we're Watson Capstone Projects Team 52. From left to right, we have John, Jeff, our faculty advisor, Professor Colin Selleck, Emily, and Dave. For the past year, we've been working on the relay vehicle competition. We were given the task to design and build four cars using different energy sources that would trigger each other. And these are their stories. The first car in our lineup is the wind vehicle, mechanically triggered and driven to win. At first, our design didn't work as we planned it. But through strong teamwork and strength of will, we adapted our designs and overcame the odds to produce a working car. Sometimes it came down to unconventional methods, to think outside the box and make it work. But it was these unconventional methods that eventually led to our final design.
For our second energy source, we wanted to have a design that was simple and reliable. After brainstorming, we decided that battery power was the best choice. At first, the design we set up did not grip the surface of the floor and the car spun out. Then, the car went too fast and almost lost control. After working together and brainstorming ideas, we were able to fix the problems the car was having.
For our next car, we decided to use a solar cell as an energy source. We ran into a few problems when designing our solar cell car. For instance, the competition takes place indoors and we are using an energy source that uses the sun. In order to fix this, we found a lamp strong enough to provide the light needed for the solar cell to power our motor. Even with the light needed for the solar cell to operate, the power being sent to the motor was not enough to move the weight of the car, but the wheels were moving on their own. After realizing this, we decided to set up a capacitor to store extra energy before the car was activated. With this new setup, we were able to get the wheels moving even faster.
The spring-powered vehicle, repurposed from a rat trap, it now runs from that which it used to ensnare.
The hands-on work done during this project helped us improve our design methodology, because it forced us to think not only about how a design would work, but how it would be put together. It turns out things don't always fit together as easily as you might have hoped. Once we had our design built, we were able to start testing, but it quickly became apparent that we were going to have to do some troubleshooting. This was a somewhat iterative process, as we would change things one at a time, and with each change we'd see a little improvement until finally we had reached our goal.
Throughout the entire process, we learned that no matter how great you think your design is, there's always work to be done and things to be perfected. It looks like we have our work cut out for us.